and the Capital Region Collaborative presentation from Wendy Burtner-Owens and the Director Executive Director of Richmond Regional Planning and Strategic Commission, Bob Crum.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Bob Crum, I'm the Executive Director of the Richmond Regional Planning and Strategic Commission. I'm joined here today by Wendy Burtner-Owens, who's to my left, who is the Project Manager of the Capital Region Collaborative. And I really appreciate the opportunity for us to spend just a few minutes with you to bring you up to date on work that's happening around a regional collaborative project, working with representatives of the City of Richmond, but also our surrounding jurisdictions, the non-jurisdictions that represent the Richmond region. We have a very brief PowerPoint presentation that we're going to call up for you today and just walk through about 5 or 6 slides. And all this with the conversation today. Okay, so what is the Capital Region Collaborative? This is basically a cooperative effort between government in the Richmond region, represented by the Richmond Regional Planning District Commission, and the business community in the Richmond region that is being coordinated through the Greater Richmond Chamber of Commerce. This effort started going back 3 to 4 years ago in earnest, where government business leaders in the community had a vision that said, what if we could bring government and business together, interacting with the greater community to identify what issues are critical to the Richmond region and how we take our metropolitan region and advance it to the next level. Starting in around 2009, we formed a council that is represented government and business leaders within the Greater Richmond region. This council currently has 36 members on it. 18 members are representatives of the government community, the 9 jurisdictions within the Richmond region. In the City of Richmond, you are represented by Kathy Garbiano and also by Susan Denzel on the Capital Region Collaborative. So we have all 9 governments represented. We also have major business leaders within the Richmond region as well. So we have 18 business leaders within the community as well. This group has been meeting monthly over the last 3 or 4 years, and really has not missed more than 1 or 2 meetings during that time to provide oversight and coordination for this effort. A big benefit of the Capital Region Collaborative is the opportunity for government and business to exchange information and ideas. But the key part of this process is quite different than anything that we've done before. It's really been a bottom-up community grassroots effort. Before we began having conversations, the first thing we were committed to doing was reaching out to the community and asking residents of the Richmond region what the important priorities should be for our community, for our metropolitan region. In 2010 and 2011, myself and Kim Schiller from the Greater Richmond Chamber, we engaged about 8,000 residents within the Richmond region in this conversation. We did 85 public meetings throughout the community. Those public meetings represented all different aspects of our community. Anyone that was willing to have this conversation with us, we went out to their meetings over about a 15-month period and had important conversations to learn just what residents of this region believe our important regional priorities should be. In addition to the public meetings, we engaged the Southeastern Institute of Research, who did a scientifically based, statistically significant sample telephone survey of all jurisdictions within the Richmond region. And that gave us another 1,500 people that participated in this process. And we used that information to settle on 7 regional priorities for the Greater Richmond region. I think you can have it in place today, I'm sure. Entitled Building the Framework for Regional Collaboration. For anybody in the audience, we've got plenty of copies and we'll be happy to share this with everyone. This is a report for the community. So, in effect, this is the community's report expressing to the Richmond region's government and business leaders what those important priorities are for the Richmond region. And you'll see there's 7 priorities that we defined. Wendy's going to talk about that in a few minutes, but these are the seven priority areas, ranging from drug prevention, workforce preparation, quality place, which quality place entails things like our culture, arts, entertainment, assets that we have in our community, the need for a coordinated regional transportation system, healthy community, which fits into the sports factors of our active urban neighborhood, but also deals with issues such as community health care for our residents, James River, and social security. So these are priorities that we centered on community health and regional collaborative. Once we went through this public participation process, we were very fortunate, through the support of the Greater Richmond Chamber Foundation, to be able to bring on board a project manager, Wendy Burtner-Owens. I'm going to set aside and allow Wendy to walk through and tell you what we're doing with this priority information now, and where we look to go to collaborate over the next year.
Thank you.